Hello, everybody, and welcome. Thank you for joining me for another episode of Ephemeral Tale, a fun retro-inspired role-playing game. As you can see, I have a new companion here from the last episode, and unfortunately, I did a whole recording, and then we had it messed up. We had no microphone in it. That is my bad, and I am sorry for that. Unfortunately, it was most of this corrupted castle. We went through it, got what we needed. We went back to the Respice and picked up this other companion because he was here. I kind of want to see what he can do. So we lost about a half an hour on gameplay, unfortunately. But this is like the old, you know, we've been through this area before. We had to chase down some ghost skeleton heads and defeat them, and they gave us these right here, these faithful essence, vigilant essence, valiant efforts, and forgotten essence. The four ghosts gave us those, and then we are going to take them on to get the blessing of the guardian of this area. I think we probably picked up a few new items in the area as well. I think a couple of these we picked up as we did that area. Another thing that I did that I'm going to switch back, we went ahead and changed this difficulty rating so that the encounter delay was higher, requiring me to do more steps before there was a chance of encounter. We went from 25, which is the default. We moved it all the way up to 100 just to see a difference. There was a dramatic difference. And then even moving it back down to 50, really felt that I was not getting the experience and the battle that I wanted. So I think for a normal playthrough, kind of a quote unquote normal difficulty, since that's not really a thing here, the 25 is a good setting. It's a good balance, in my opinion, from what I've played so far of this game, and this is the second playthrough of here, so that's kind of where we're at and kind of what I think about that. I have not messed with any other of the difficulty options. The other ones are pretty standard. You got your enemy strength, so your percentage, you can make them percentage stronger or percentage weaker. Your enemy toughness impacts how much damage an enemy can take before dying. So that's going to be set up that, you know, it's going to be some percentage of that. And then the power rate, you can make it them stronger or weaker, however you want it. But from my experience so far, it seems like these settings are a good balance for a normal difficulty. It's pretty much what I like and what I expect. Now, when we first poked our nose in here after gathering the essence, we did end up fighting a little boss type creature, but I believe we have to go in here. Energy, yeah, let's see what I think I'm supposed to go through here and do. Well, no, I'm fighting this girl again. Okay, so it says I have the blessing, which makes me a little confused because let's see what he has. He has cleave, taunt, rally, and then just an attack. Let's see what his attack goes. That's actually not too bad, his straight attack. We're gonna go through here and see what we could do. I'd like to see what cleave does. It does a massive swipe through all the foes, but I only have one foe, so not that going to be that helpful. This is the person here, and it's not really what I was expecting here. I went back in the episode that I messed up. I went back and talked to the guy that gives you the quest, and he didn't seem to do anything. I had to do something else, and I was confused about what that was supposed to be. So I thought it was to go through this doorway, but I guess I am wrong. We're gonna just go ahead and go through here, defeat her, Go back and see what he says again. See what I was missing. Maybe I need to open something. My mind is a sieve. Things go in and they go right back out of it. Remembering what I did last time is sometimes a little bit of a difficulty, but we'll push through this battle really quick. We'll get it some experience. We'll head back out and we'll try to figure out what we're supposed to open. We're supposed to take the essences or the blessings that we have gotten, as far as I could remember, and then open a new doorway. But unfortunately, I don't remember where that doorway is or how to get to it. We'll go back and explore that here in a little bit. Siegfried is getting pretty hurt here. Let's go and attack. And I'm not sure which one has a stronger. I think since I'm doing, let's go ahead and use me. Let's heal Siegfried up and then go ahead and attack. We have about the same, I feel, straight attack, about the same damage, about the 80s. That's what I was gonna say, low 80s or somewhere around in there is usually what we hit, unless we crit, which is nice. So we got her killed. We got a couple new items, nothing major. Oh, there's a chest over here, so let's go check that out. I really didn't like, a whip. Wonder what a whip does. I feel that would be fun to play with. Increases attack and magic attack when at low HP. Nah, I, as a general rule, love the concept of whips. I don't know why. In a game that has whips, I really want to use a whip. It's just something that always intrigues me. Unfortunately, a lot of the games, they really don't give whips the power that I would like to see from a whip. So I don't really like him. I definitely liked Merlin better, the magician over here. So we're gonna switch back to him. His gust did a lot of damage. So let's go ahead and replace Sigmund there. And let's talk to him and see what he says. See if I can figure this out. You've came a long way to get to this point, awakening the ancients, besting their challenges, gathering their strengths. There remains only one step left to gather what we've worked so much for. Now, Stingray, awaken the power you've gathered, infuse the crystals with the blessings of the ancients. Infuse the crystal. Oh, I bet I know what I need to do. I bet I know what we're gonna have to do is go up here and infuse these crystals in here with the ancients, the blessings of the ancients here. So I'm gonna assume maybe infuse these crystals. Yeah, there we go. That seemed a little much more simpler than what I was thinking. For some reason, I was expecting it to be much more difficult than that. So we got the crystals infused and something, it's shaking. Something's happening. I don't like it. Something happened, but I don't. Oh, it's back outside. Yeah, leave. This is where, I'm not sure what happened. I was thinking this is where it turned all like dead and all the trees and the grass ended up dying. But there was a new door that opened somewhere. Was it? Okay, let's see what he says. He'll give us a clue. You've held me dormant all this time. The old ones would have been proud. They have survived Le Song. I must say, Stingray, you're far more effective than I could ever hope for. Where all the others failed, you succeeded. I can see why the ancients gave you their blessing so willingly. And now, thanks to you, I can be free of both this form and you. Uh-oh. That's not good. Ghost guy, come back. The time has come. Ooh, your story is not yet written. So now we have a little ghost here. What? I've done what I can to mend your wounds. Apologies, it isn't perfect. Thank you for breaking their hold over me. Let me introduce myself. Hello, Stingray. I'm glad to finally meet you. However, the circumstances with which we met are troubled. In short, I am the true keeper. Over the many years this place has existed, my duty to it as well has existed. It's been called many things, but the duty has been the same. That duty is to watch over the place to the north, the Great Palace, the Lost Prison, the Forgotten Tower. As I told you, it has many names. This place was built to hold a great evil until that day came that a hero could vanquish it. Yet even after these many years, it was you who heard my voice, Stingray. I believe that you're the one meant to vanquish what lies in waiting. In order to vanquish the great evil, though, requires passing through the final challenges you'll face on your journey. You're ready now. Do you remember the place where you first heard my voice? Return there. Hidden within is a path forward. A rift lies between a key and a lock. Okay, so we first heard his voice is in the cave. So let's head back up to the cave and see what we can find in there. I think we do a little bit in here and then it opens up the winter place. And we take care of that. But again, I don't know where the three new areas are. Let's go through this hole. This is what where the rocks came down and blocked our path. I don't know when the three new areas will be introduced. Okay, we are some wait. The nearby area seems different than before. What could have happened? Long ago, I was like you, drawn to this place. I sought to enact change. My journey, like yours, it would lead me to this place. These caverns serve a dual purpose, as a barrier and a gateway. Seek me outside. Let's go see if we can find out what's going on. The pillars are all rebuilt. So did we like jump back in time? I think that's what happened. Going off of kind of the playthrough in the last playthrough in this, it looks like we jumped back in time. There's the real keeper, I guess. Ah, you've made it. I suppose you'll be looking for some explanation, Stingray. Very well. I owe at least that much to you. The Lost Caverns exist as both a barrier and a gateway. You see, the caverns hold traces of magic long lost, the purpose of which to find those with a strong will. A rift lies between a key and lock. The key, blessings, the lock, you. As I told you, the Great Palace was built to hold a great evil. But perhaps it would be best to start at the beginning. Let me tell you of the Traveler's Tale. This is but one of the legends of which the people speak. Long ago, a dark evil roamed the lands of this world. Though many attempts were made, none could vanquish the great evil. And over time, the people grew unable to protect themselves from it. But then, when the veil of darkness touched upon every surface, a light flickered. Slowly, the veil of darkness began to fray apart. Well, that's kind of cool. That is a really cool image. from the ravaged lands, a hero rose. Would that be the Keeper? It's not telling our story, is it? I don't think so. With renewed hopes, more lights grew bright in these hearts. From the frozen wastes. From the safety of their cities. From the cursed marshes. Together, their light pushed back against the great evil. And thus, their tale became legend. But now, the veil of darkness is falling once more. And a new legend must be written. That's where I come in. Remember it well, Stingray. The tale has been passed to all beckoned by this place. You are not the first, and surely not the last. The lost caverns exist as both a barrier and a gateway. You see, the caverns hold a trace of magic long ago, the purpose of which is to find those with a strong will. That portal is a window of sorts that allows for travel between realms, the realm we know of, and a mirrored version of that world. If we stem from the realm of light, then this place would be the realm of shadows, okay? In this realm, things are not dissimilar to what you know. Rather, they are best viewed as twisted versions of those things. But we've an issue, my dearest Stingray. As I told you, the Great Palace was built to hold a great evil. A rift lies between key and lock. The key, blessing, the lock, you. While the realm of light contains a great palace, it is not the great palace. In truth, it lies here, cloaked in shadow, hidden in plain sight, if you would. Come, there is something you must see. Ooh, what is he going to show me? Do I go in? Yeah, let's go ahead and open the door. I bet he went into the palace. Here he is. Did you notice anything, dearest Stingray? As the blessings were in our realm of light, so are they in this realm of shadow. We've made a grave error. Here we are, dearest Stingray, in the shadow of the great palace. Whether by malice or not, something has pierced the veil between realms. I regret to inform you that the blessings you've collected, unfortunately, the corruption of this place has tainted them. However, as this place is a shadow of our realm, perhaps we can reverse the damage and make our way to the top of the Great Palace. There, we should be able to vanquish the great evil. I'll need your help, however. The corruption that has shown its way into the Great Palace in this realm originates from this chamber. In order for us to stem the damage, you'll need to cleanse the corruption at its source. Like guardians to their blessings, are this realm's protectors to their curses. As such, you'll need to take the blessings to three shrines deep within this realm and seek them out. The Graveyard Grove, the Bayou Bog, the Royal Rose Garden. The three new areas that were added in the large patch a couple weeks ago. Only then we'll be able to open the path that we need in order to follow the imposter. Whenever you are finished, you can charge the crystals using the cleansed blessing. Let me warn you, Stingray, those that you've already fought have become further empowered. As such, you should be wary while on your adventure. Ooh, okay, that's interesting. All three areas are opened. I'm not sure which. This is probably the Bayou I bet this is the graveyard, and I bet you this is the garden. These, an unpowered runic crystal, perhaps a blessing could power it? Okay, so we need to go in here and find each of these. Let's go into the garden and see what it is. Check it out for a little bit and see what trouble we can get into. The Royal Rosegarden. Let's see what we can find in here and explore. What is this? Is that just, okay, nothing? This is a whole new area. I've not seen this before. We have not played. This is one of the new areas that was added in the patch. This is an early access game and patches are coming through. Oh, I can't go that way. So, you know, we need to, this is, they've added three new areas and this is one of them. Okay, so we need to figure out how to get those spikes down. Is going to be one of the things we need to figure out how to do. And I hope, I'm worried now. We haven't hit enemy. Oh, there we go. I still say we haven't hit any in. Oh, never mind. Oh, cool. We got some swords. And oh no, I have no magic either. So we got a blade hilt and a Leogrim. I have no idea. Ouch. That was a hard hit. A very hard hit. Shock, deal shock damage to all enemies. We need to get these guys. Dang, that guy hit super hard. Like 150 there right off the bat. That's just horrible. Let's try storm. No, well, let's wait until there's three of them. And see, or more of these guys all at once. Let's, until we do the lightning one. It probably will be pretty powerful, but I'm sure I want to see it. There we go, a nice critical hit. Finish that well. A librarian's sharp bookmark and a pointed helm. I hope that levels us up very quickly. To be honest with you, that didn't go well. No, I think I'm gonna stay with that, but Vengeance Whip, Devourer's Edge. Yeah, I'm not sure I want really any of these. The Mallet's pretty nice. I get a lot of on attack, but then my defense goes down really bad. I think I wanna stay with that. What was the other thing we got? The Pointed Helm? No, Masquerade, what's this do? That's all magic and agility. That's not really, it does move my HP and my magic up a little bit, but not as much as I would hoped. Or not real, I don't really want, that's not, I mean, it's important, but I'd rather have my attack moved up, to be perfectly honest with you. Let's, yeah, that didn't go very well for us, I gotta say. Let's do a flask here to heal us up. And then how many magic water? We got 33 magic water, so there we go. That should be a good start. That was a hard battle. I mean, not, we won it, but I was really surprised about how hard they hit there. I'm gonna go, let's just go left. We're gonna just keep on going left as we play through this, because that's, if I'm lost, that's usually my ticket to find my way around, is always go left. A stimulant. So we could go left and we go up here, that's blocked, so we have to come back out around. Then the next left is up here. It's just a nice way to take, if you're in a maze-like area, it's a nice way to make sure that you cover all the areas. Oh, we got another piglet. But that piglet is probably harder hitting than the, let's see what this lightning does. Harder hitting than the previous one that was in one of the other earlier areas. 60 across the board, not, I wouldn't say horrible. I guess the shock could help me out. If it critted on one of them or something, I mean, it could be a possibility where it could be useful. I'm gonna get him out right here, I believe, with this. Yeah, there we go. A little worried about Merlin. He doesn't have a lot of health there. We're gonna have to make sure that he has plenty of health potions to stay nice and healthy. I do get, ooh, there's something there. I want to see if that's a authorization required. Please provide passcode, password. Uh-oh, defense sequence. Oh no, that's not good. Omega bot. Ouch, that was maybe a bad idea. Let's see if we can get this guy down without too much trouble. A nice crit would be, yeah, very helpful. I do believe he's gonna be a little bit of a trouble here. We might end up knocking him down without, those crits are very nice. And he's miss, oh no. Okay, yeah, that's not good. I was hoping that something, this might be the guy that we need. We have flask on me. And then this, yeah, like I said, this might be the guardian of this area. I don't know. Item, I want a potion on Merlin. And then Merlin's gust does a lot more damage than what I'm doing. So that's why I'm kind of using that to begin with. And hopefully if we could just get through the Omega bot, we will be a lot better off. Oh no, we're gonna, I'm actually a little worried about this right now. We get that Omega bot taken care of. I think the other two little guys are going to be much easier to take care of. Here we go. Dust mini bots probably are not hitting as hard as the big guy and probably doesn't have as much health. There we go. We got one taken out. I'd be surprised kind of if this was the, you know, the guardian here, but it's acting like the guardian. We won. We didn't get any items for that. That's not cool at all. I got a tainted edge and a small key, but that tainted edge was not, yeah, it was, it's green and it moves everything down. Wow, that was quite an interesting little battle there, and there is more to explore in the Guardian Gardens, and we are going to have to save that for the next episode. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. There will be more to come as we explore the three new areas. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye, everybody.